Hey campers, Ben from Snowy's here today. This is the companion 75 litre single zone fridge freezer. This is a large volume single zone fridge freezer, probably ideal for caravans or larger vehicles. If you need that cold zone to store those extra big fish that you've been catching, or you like to take a lot of cold food with you when you go camping. And this guy weighs in at 27 kilos, measures about 66 centimetres in length, and that includes these handles on the ends here, 52 centimetres in depth, that sort of includes the hinge at the back and the latch at the front, and about 67 centimetres in height to the very sort of top. This sort of arches a little bit here. It's made on the exterior predominantly of a steel. This is a steel, this gray material here, and there's metal, plastic components on the corners here, around the top, and also at the base, there's a couple little plastic bumpers down here. The handles and latches are all steel. If we have a look around the side here, we've got these spring-loaded handles here with sort of a soft, well not soft, but a firm nylon grab portion in the middle there to make it comfortable to carry. Metal latches on the front here, two metal latches, and if I flick it around to the rear, we've got these that we'll show you when we open it, but they're plastic covers over metal brackets there. Not much more to see on the outside. There's vents down the bottom here and our two our power input there, which we'll show you shortly. Got a control panel on the front here, which we'll go into shortly as well. And on the other side here, not much to see, just a blank portion, same as the back. There's nothing to see except some vents for the compressor there. Now, with your fridge, you get a manual, which is going to show you a lot of all the sort of intricate details that we're not going to go into in this video here today, regarding battery voltage cutouts and all those sort of things. So check that. This covers all the different sizes in this series, but you do get 24 volt cable here, which has got either a cigarette or a merit plug on there. You can take that plastic cap off to turn that into a merit plug. And you also get a 240 volt converter. Now these both plug into the same port on the side here. So it's the same plug for both of those cables. Plugs in here, and I'm going to plug this now into a 240 volt power source so we can show you how the panel on the front here works. Now we've got the control panel like had it on the front here, which tells the compressor obviously what we want it to do. Now just on the compressor, it's an LG dual speed compressor. Not a compressor we've seen in a lot of fridges that we've got in our range, but it is a reputable brand. So it's not just sort of a cheapo that they put in there just to bring the price down. Now the control panel is located in the bottom right hand corner here near the compressor. It makes it easily accessible no matter where the fridge is installed. You don't have to reach up over the back of the fridge to reach any controls. Now I'll do a bit of a tour around of the panel here. Now when you first plug the fridge in, it goes to the last setting you had it on. So if I was to unplug this fridge and unplug it back in, this would go on automatically. If I press this power button here, which turns it off, unplug it and plug it back in, it remembers that I had it off last time, and it will be off when I plug it into the power supply. So it does have a memory, but this is the actual on off button on the unit here, which lights up this panel here. Now there's a few things going on here. Little battery indicator here, that tells us what the voltage is at the input, the cable going into the side here. So it's anywhere from about 12.5 volts. I think when it's completely full like this, if it's down to just sort of one bar, it's well below 10 volts. So if you're running it from a battery, it's indicating that the battery itself is getting pretty flat. This here is showing us the temperature inside the actual cabinet at the moment. Below this, we've got the battery protection indicator. That is controlled through the battery protection button here. If we press that, it scrolls between high, low, medium, high, low, medium. So up and down, depending on what voltage we want it to cut out on to protect the battery. A bit more information on that in the user manual. Below that is a compressor speed. Now we've got, that's operated by the compressor speed button here. We've got max and eco. Use max to bring the temperature down quickly. Use eco once the temperature's at the temperature you want it to be at so that you conserve battery power. Now the last thing to show you is these plus and minus symbols here, which is actually setting the temperature inside the unit. We press plus, you can see this starts to flash. That's the temperature that we're setting it to, or the target temperature for the compressor. So I'll put that on 5. It can go anywhere from plus 20 down to minus 20 degrees. So you can use it as a fridge or a freezer, not both, because it's just a single compartment. That'll flash and then return to a solid number, and that's indicating once again the temperature inside the unit there. So it makes a pretty simple operation for the panel on the front here. Let's jump over and have a look inside the fridge here. Now the lid, secured by these two latches, does have a bit of an assisted or soft close sort of feature on it, so it doesn't just open and close uncontrollably. These metal hinges, you can see the metal at the back here beneath those plastic covers, kind of open automatically and just give it a bit of a soft close feature when you close it down. Now around the lid here, there's a nice big thick seal to keep the cold air trapped inside the fridge, and that sits inside this ridge around here. You can see the edge has got about, it's about 6 to 6.5 centimeters of PU insulation around the side here, so really thick insulation. Inside the fridge is a removable basket. It's a single basket that's cut to fit the shape of the fridge. So this is the cutout where the compressor sits. If we have a look inside the fridge, we can see we've got one large compartment. Talking about dimensions inside the fridge before I go into too many more details, it's about 49.5 centimeters from edge to edge here, about 35.5 centimeters width this way, and then there's two different depths, so 52 centimeters thereabouts from the bottom to the this sort of top edge here of the deeper portion, and about 34 centimeters on the top of this shelf to this point here as well. So heaps of room inside the fridge here, and plenty of room for upright bottles as well. I've got a couple of bottles here at the moment we can put inside, and you can see you can just about, well, not quite fit one on top of the other, but heaps of vertical space for tall bottles inside the fridge here. Other features inside, if you have a look around the front here, we've got a little LED light here that just gives us a bit of visibility at night, and probably a bit hard to see, but right down the bottom here there is a little sort of, it's a not mesh, but it's an open plastic panel. Inside that is the temperature gauge, so that's where it's reading the temperature from inside the cabinet. It's probably just worth mentioning that the internal dimensions I gave you probably just need to take a little bit off to allow for the width of the basket here, because that sits inside and just takes a bit of width and depth off of that. So if you're cutting it fine, just give yourself a little bit of room for error there. I don't think I've actually mentioned current draw yet either, which Companion says about 1.3 amps on average. So that's usually measured over 24 hours with the cycling in and out. So it's pretty good current draw for a fridge of this size. 70 litres total volume, heaps of space for loads of food, or if you plan on catching some pretty big fish, you're going to fit it inside there nice and easily. So a great fridge for family camping with big parties, or if you're catering for yourself and some other people, this is certainly going to suit. Other options you've got with or other accessories you can get, there's no dedicated fridge slide for this guy, and there's no nutserts in the bottom. Some fridges will have screws points in the bottom so you can fix it down. This doesn't feature that. You're going to have to use these handles to use a rope or straps to actually secure it down in the back of your car. It is designed to be mounted in a protected area inside a caravan or a vehicle, not on the back of the boat or exposed on the back of a ute or anything like that. It needs to be in a weather protected area. You can though get a protective cover for it as an accessory. This is available as an extra. This is going to improve the efficiency of the fridge a little bit and also offer a bit of protection on the outside. There's a slightly padded insulation there. It's got a panel here so you can still use the control panel there. Mesh around the side so the compressor can still breathe, and a couple of just storage pockets on the front here so you can get a few extra organization options. It's pretty much all the features of the 75 litre, I think I've said 70 litre, it is a 75 litre fridge, not 70, from Companion. Use it as a fridge or a freezer, tons of volume inside, could even get you out of trouble if you're at home and your fridge breaks down, or keep heaps of drinks in there on Christmas Day, cold on your deck. You can check these out online at snowys.com.au, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. If you've got any questions though, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest info, or check out some other Companion products like these ones down here.